Alright, ladies and gentlemen, my name is Shane, this is Shane is Games, and tonight, on this very special Christmas Shane is Games, we are playing Dragon's Dogma Dark Arisen. This will be our very first time playing it, so you didn't miss anything. If you want to see any of the previous things I have streamed, though, feel free to click on my YouTube link in the info below. I archive all my streams there. I'll be archiving this once I am done playing it as well. But for the moment, let's get started, shall we? Alright, so like I said, I really don't know much about this game, so I'm going to be going in very blind. I learned a couple things just looking up maybe how I should start in a couple particular things, like, mechanically, but that's about it. And as always, we're starting in normal difficulty. A vast army formed to slay a... Ooh, that... Hope that was important. In another place, in another life, another child of man blazes your path. So, have you a light source? What I'm told is here, going on here, is there was a comic that was like a prequel to Dragon's Dogma that you can get online somewhere. And so, this that you're playing as the prologue of the game is basically the end of the prequel comic storyline, which is a hella weird place to start a game. Because I didn't read the comic and I have no idea what's going on. The final station of our long struggle. Ooh, hey! That's a... Whoa, jeez. Oh, jeez! Alright. Really can't fight you when you're over there. Don't have any ranged attacks, but oh, you're... You leaving? What's going on here? Okay. Guess he's leaving. Alright, so, here's our first fight. You can see the controls on screen. As you can see, they're nothing too complicated. And as you can see, this is going to be a third-person action RPG. Which is something I like. Invoking this stone can gain you new allies known as pawns, whose loyalty in battle will never falter. May be used to summon pawns from beyond. So pawns are, from what I understand, basically NPC companions. As you progress in your adventures, pawns will provide you with useful information and hints. Actually, while I'm thinking about it, let me do one thing real quick. I think I'm going to go into gameplay and turn on pawn subtitles, because it's a little hard to hear what they're saying, and I don't know if it's actually going to be important. So we'll see how irritating this gets. And if it is, we can go ahead and turn it off later. Alright, let's press on. Avoid stepping in the fire. They're all coming. Alright, so I can issue them commands with the F keys. Alright, so at least there he's talking about plot and important stuff, so... Yeah, that is something I wanted to hear about. Alright, so, trying to work out my block there is all. Seems doable. Alright, there's some little boxes around here. I'm going to break those to see if there's any goodies. I don't actually know if boxes drop goodies in here, but only one way to find out. Oh, that one did. There's some sort of herbs? Alright. Let's see, anything else? They are really chatty. Really chatty. I'm coming. Cripes. Alright, so... Cinema? Oh, hello. He's a big dude. I assume I'm gonna have to fight him in a bit. Goblins? Where? I don't see any goblins.
The worm must be made to settle this. A flying beast arisen!
Oh good, enemy with no ranged attacks. Ugly looking guy though. There we go. Where'd he go? I thought I knocked him down. Oh, he must have knocked him back as well. Well, that kind of sucks. Come on, bring him. Ooh, flies in the tunnel. That actually might make things easier. There we go. That got him. That's what you get for flying indoors, Harpy. He's still fighting somebody back here. Oh, there's some. Oh, there were some goblins back here. Where did they come from? Oh, in here. All right. Little prison cells.
Mighty beast, not the worm.
All right. Wow, they're really chatty. It's a little hard to keep up with everything they're saying. Hey, there's a dude in there. Can I get the dude out? Oh, he's through here.
Sheer numbers, a sea of blades. 'Twas a fool's hope. Our sea runs dry, and the Duke's army is lost in the gambit. Arisen, I beg you, sir, grant vengeance to those who've fallen. If this be of use, I would give it gladly.
All right, some sort of healing item, I assume. I should check out my items before I get too far. Or no, it's I for inventory. Alright. Materials, keys, other. Alright. Curatives. Alright, so pretty much everything I got is some sort of curative. I got an anti-poison. Let's assign that to 3. And let's put this on 2. Maybe, and that on 4. Sure, why not? Alright, moving on. As a broadcaster, never smell your microphone. Oh, jeez. That sounds disgusting, Zero. You don't hear any in-game sound? It's a little quiet right now, especially outside of combat. I think I'm about to get in another fight. If you don't see anything, hear anything here, Zero, let me know. I'll see about it. Yeah, you should be hearing something from me fighting the goblins right here. I think that was a cinematic kill, but I couldn't actually tell what he was doing to the guy there. You should be able to hear the pawns being chatty behind me as well. Ooh. Wow, knockdown took a long time to get back up for him. Okay, oh, that's what she was doing, casting a fireball at that harpy. Nice. Alright, good deal. The harpy trying to pick up that pawn over there? You want me to turn up the in-game sound, Zero? Honestly, it's a little quiet for me too, but it's turned up as high as it'll go in-game, so I'd have to turn it up in OBS. But I'd be able to do that if that's what's necessary. Let's see. Something else? Oh. One little straggler from the group, I guess. Alright. Ooh, hey, chest over here. You still fighting something? Not here for in-game sound anyway. Appreciate Zero.
Lure them down and strike.
Alright, I might have to turn off that cinematic camera. That is super dumb. Right, let's get this last harpy and then check out that chest over there. This is interesting so far, but I'm going to give pretty much any third-person RPG a lot of leeway because I love them so much. Harspid juice. I think that was some sort of healing item, but I don't remember what. Are we going over here? Oh yeah, it's a sea gate over there.
Arisen! This way, sir! Let's hasten to the
dragon's roost. Okie dokie.
I'm
away to be on, sir.
I should be proud to guide you. By, Arisen. Stay ever ready as we advance. For fear of beasts.
So happy!
There's so much chatter going on in this game. This way, sir. Kind of bizarre. I'm not used to having characters, NPCs, talk over each other like this. Plain truth.
Beyond that grand door, the dragon makes its roost.
Beyond this grand door? Oh, crap. Oh, rip Sir Pilati. And this dude's huge, so that could be a problem. Let's fight the dude. Ooh, alright, so this is chaotic already. And I don't seem to be doing quite as much damage as I'd like here. I also can't really tell. Unfortunately, because of the snake, how high up it is with the camera, I'm having trouble getting a read on when it's going to strike. Ooh. But I think I'd like to start from the back since they're distracting it from the front for the most part. Alright. So the health bar at the top seems to be its overall health. Alright, cool. Took down the snake. Ooh, alright, I knocked it down. Well, that did some good damage. Alright. Yeah, we're doing good here. We're doing good, I think. Alright, so she just cast something. Is it just a silent spell? Anti-magic? Hard to tell. Alright, knock down again. I like that they keep knocking it down. That makes it handy. Alright, don't focus on me. Focus on the pawns. Don't mind me. Oh, jeez. I'm just gonna keep circling. Keep taking on the pawns. No, no, not me. Not me. Not me. Alright, cool, it's two heads down. I don't have a Micah boom arm, so I'm not sure what the thump thump is. Focus on the buttons! Yes! Ooh! That hit me. Oh wow, he keeps knocking me back. Doesn't seem to be doing any damage when he roars, though. Ooh. I guess you could be hearing the mouse clicking, or me hitting the keys on the, oh, you might be hearing me mash on the keys on the keyboard, that could be. I haven't quite gotten that. Sweet! Killed him! Nice! Alright then. First boss taken care of.
Now choose, flee, or step forth. Take hold of what lies beyond. Claim mastery over the eternal ring.
I want eternal rings. I'll take that. Yeah. Let's do that. No, I don't have an ad quote system yet, Zero. I'd like to add that later on. And countless lifetimes come to pass. I'm not even going to try and pronounce that. I'd know zero French. The delightful and ever novel pleasure of useless occupation. What in the hell is the context of that? Alright, I'll let the cinema play out for you folks, because this is beautiful. Giant beef jerky. Yeah, get me some of that. Sign me up for giant flying beef jerky. I think I could deal with that. So I have no idea what's going on. I was in the intro, now I'm not in the intro. Alright, choose our gender. View poses. Alright, so what do I want to take? Boring generic male or boring generic female? I'll just take boring generic male for right now. Why not? Please enter a name. Invalid characters will be changed to asterisk. Alright. Shane is games. That's my name. Enter. Moniker. Your moniker will display for players with parental controls enabled. What do I want the kiddies to think my name is? Let's take a look. I will tell the kiddies that my name is... Let's see if we can find something in the neighborhood. Hey kids, my name is... Cheeden. Shinra? Shunui! Let's go Shippu. Shippu is games. There we go. There's my moniker. Continue. Alright, base body. Let's see, who looks interesting out of these? Not a hobbit. Let's just not take the hobbit. Or a gigantic dude, no. I don't know. I'm probably going to go pretty boring, because that's how I roll. Yeah, I kind of just like the first guy. He's alright. Yeah, let's go with first guy. And then let's pick a voice. Always very important. Shippu Shane with taters. I'd hope so. That is a good ship. Stick with that one. It'll take you far. Oops, no, I didn't want to pick that one. I just wanted to hear how it sounded. Alright, edit basic information. Yes? No, wait, hang on. Oh, alright, so I gotta do that. Test voice, alright. With O? That's weird. So many choices. So many choices. I'm not gonna take one of the baby voices because that would drive me insane. The all-important voice phase. Gotta pick a voice that I'm not gonna get sick of by the end of the game. I think I'm gonna take type 3. Pick a deep voice like yours. I don't know, whenever I hear a deep voice in games like this, like that big "oh" voice you heard, I always just think of some like big burly ogre dude. And I'm like, that's not the kind of character I'm playing, so it doesn't feel like it fits for me, you know? Like, I oftentimes try to make characters look like me, certainly, but... I don't know, it feels weird putting a deep voice on somebody. Possibly because it doesn't feel like my voice fits my, my look. Alright, so we got the name right, moniker, gender, voice, height and weight are acceptable. Alright, yeah, let's roll with this guy. Today, like every day, waves gently lap at the shore near your tiny village. They really don't want me reading those things, it would seem. And there's me, my big barrel-chested beauty. God, I'm handsome. Oh, see, that loading screen text was actually relevant to what's happening right now. Something about Seaside Village. Would have been nice if I got to read it, but whatever. I'm so pretty.
The prophets have spoken, friends. The dragon's return is nigh. Join the honorable duke's ranks and help us be rid of the fell beast. The day's come to lay down rod and reel and take up the sword.
What was that?
It's the dragon!
Wait, but no, I didn't pick up my sword yet. I'm still just a humble fisherman, wait! Ah, crap. So since he's here now, I'm assuming guy at the start of the game and the intro didn't fare so well against him. Nice going, dude. You had one job. You had one job. Oh, jeez. I like the game's graphics. Everything is very pretty. Lighting in particular is very nice. Welp! There's some chaos going on. You marry that dragon! You're welcome to it, Zero. Though I think you might find her temperament a little scaly. Oh! Oh sure, this'll end well. Hey, just grab your sword and charge him. Man, I had better hope I am the chosen one or this is gonna end in tragedy. But of course I'm playing a video game, so probably. All about the puns. Pressing X will draw your primary weapon. Alright, sure! Get in there and attack him. Oh my god, look at those dots are his health bars. I don't seem to be doing any damage to him. Nope, not doing any damage to him. Maybe I gotta hit him in the head. Sure, that's a good idea, right? Or maybe the soft underbelly? Keeps moving around, though. Oh. I don't think it's working, guys! I'm real sorry about that, dude. That was probably somebody else's sword. Oh, he's mad. So, last will and testament. I'd like all my things to go to my family. I regret every decision I've ever made up to this point. They were clearly all mistakes to bring me to this moment. Sure, whatever you just said. Yeah, your mother too. Bastard. Oh, he's gonna do a thing. Oh, jeez. Hey, that's mine. I need that. Don't. Is he talking Latin? Sounds like he's talking Latin. No, wait, hang on, I need that. No, that's, I want that back. Careful what you do with that. I guess I could load it to you very briefly, but... Oh, jeez. So that's Dragon's Dogma, ladies and gentlemen. I hope you guys enjoyed it. As they roll the credits. So Dragon's Dogma is a game where you're a fisherman, you fight a dragon very badly, and then get your heart eaten. Apparently. I know! He didn't even ask first, Zero! How rude is that? What? How am I still alive? Why is the hole sealed up in my chest? That's just bizarre. How am I alive again? Pirate's life for me. Oh hey, a shitty sword. Seriously, that sword looks freaking terrible. Like, there's like rusty swords that you start at level 1, but I'm looking at that weapon right there, and it just kind of makes me want to find the blacksmith and punch him in the face. How could you? It's time for you to begin your journey as Arisen, but before you can win your heart back from the dragon, you'll need to prepare. How long does this game last? Does it last in, like, the 5 minutes before I bleed to death, or... How do I not... Alright, so there's weapons. Newly Arisen, take a weapon. Examine. What do we got here? Your vocation determines your basic attributes, wieldable equipment, and skills. Alright, so we've got Fighter, of course. We've got Strider, who is the thief at the piers, and Mage, who is the mage. Let's see, details. So he starts with a exploding fireball spell, and ooh, a group healing spell. I like those. So, let's see, what does the Strider get? Because I usually like taking the archer dude. But I like the idea of having a healing skill to start out with, so I think I'm probably going to start with Mage. I have no idea how the magic system in this game works, but yeah. What the hell, let's go for Mage. Take on this vocation? Hell yeah! I'm a magic dude. That's going to be my excuse why I survived having my heart ripped out, because I'm all magical and stuff. I like the idea that I just picked up a staff and now I'm a mage. My training was lifting that thing and putting it on my back. You can equip yourself with a primary and a secondary weapon. Primary weapons such as swords and daggers are combat essentials. Secondary weapons like bows and shields offer support. Alright, cool. What is that? Is that my spell? It's kind of sad. I want to smash that pot, but I can't seem to get down to it. There we go. My character is really bad at pot smashing, apparently. That's not going to serve me well. Small nut. Blank scroll. I have no idea what that's used for. But it's an RPG, which means first order of business is pick up frickin' everything. Sure, why not? I'll take it all. Give me your stuff. I don't even know whose house I'm in right now. Hopefully nobody I like, because I'm breaking all their stuff. Oh, apparently that pot's indestructible. How nice for it. Oh, hey, some gold. Hope the guy was rich, too, because now I'm taking his money. I'm kind of a jerk, is what I'm finding out in this game. I'm kind of a jerk. Not the best thing to find out in real life, but in a video game, just kind of a fact. So, it turns out I'm a jerk. Did I just take a rock? I don't think I really needed that. Oh well. Oh, there's people in here.
What? Why is this happening? Oh, the horror. The horror of it.
Alright. So, what happens next? Left a glowing
If you would face me.
You are sure of this?
Yes.
Ill magic, the work of some curse.
Uh-oh.
The whole world's already gone mad for fear of this dragon. Won't no good come of this. I must go see to the others, Kina. Tell me if aught changes here.
All right.
Oh, good. So they think I'm cursed or something. That'll help things. Hey, lady. So about you tattling on the village elder to me. Defeating foes and completing quests earns you experience, and each level gained raises all of your attributes. Press escape to bring up the pause menu where you can check your attributes, a full map, quest information, and more. Let's have a chat first.
You should be abed. I wish you would not strain yourself so. I'm worried for you, cuz.
I'm fine. I think it's really healthy after you've been sick to get up, move around a little bit, just go into somebody's house, just break all their stuff. I think it's really good. Good for the constitution, you know what I'm saying? I feel better already, as a matter of fact. I think the very act of smashing everything this guy owns has really done wonders for my health overall. I'd really recommend it to everybody. If you're not feeling great, just wander into somebody's house. Just break everything. Like, if there's something in there that looks like you can break it by swinging a heavy object at it, just go for it. Just go nuts. Go insane on that stuff. Pots especially. There's something magically gratifying about breaking pots. I don't know what it is. I wouldn't want to argue with it. It's just nature. The way of the universe. Always talk to the people you meet, they'll surely have aught to do for you. People who bear an icon above their head possess special information. Those bearing green icons have new quests to offer. Alright, so... Look for big exclamation points above people's heads, like in every other RPG. Can do! While I continue breaking stuff. I have no idea what any of these items do. Some items can be combined with others to produce surprising effects. Experiment and see what you come up with. Ooh, crafting. I am really bad at crafting in video games. Probably because it just makes me space out. Especially when it's like, yo, experiment and see what you can find. Well, I don't wanna. Just tell me what to do. Tell me how to make the things. Oh, hey, it's my house. Alright, I know I said do it in other people's houses, but maybe do it in your own house, too. Why not? Ooh, I can hit this box, but it's indestructible. Oh, no! Sweet, nothing can stand up to my amazing big staff thing. Alright. Man, these houses are very sparse. I almost feel bad about breaking what meager things these people have. Almost. I mean, this is my house, so I'm just breaking my own stuff, but clearly I'm about to be leaving on some giant epic quest and I'll never be coming back here again, so what does it even matter, really? For realsies. Oh, holy, sorry about that. Didn't mean to whack you with my staff. Didn't actually think that would happen.
Have you seen Cortez, cousin? I have not seen my brother since the dragon came. He's not among the injured either.
Yeah, he might have gotten eaten. That kind of happened to some people.
Fortune sees fit for us to live in interesting times. Imagine our village playing host to a dragon.
Well, that's a very dry way of putting it.
I simply cannot fathom why a dragon would harass a people such as us.
Oh my god, I kind of am not a fan of the voice direction in this game so far. Everyone sounds so dry and matter-of-fact about everything. Also very British. Which I suppose sometimes goes hand in hand, if I want to be a jerk about it. Which I do. I don't even know if I need to be smashing all this stuff, or if all I'm getting is terrible low-level garbage that I'm not going to care about, but It's a video game. It has trained me in certain ways. Hey, buddy.
Tempest will burn the whole world up, way I see it. Save someone can stop him.
What does the voice acting in this game remind me of? Oh, sorry. I'm not gonna have many friends in this village when this is all done. I seem to be beating all of them up. The voice acting kind of reminds me of Xenoblade Chronicles, where everyone was just a little bit too enthusiastic. I felt, anyway. It was a pretty fun game. I'd never finished it, but I enjoyed what I played of it, but it always felt like everyone was very excited about all the things at all the times. And so, the voice acting was not one of the stronger points of the game in there. Alright, there's a chest inside the box. That's weird. And the door is automatically closed behind you. How polite. What a polite village this is. The village itself is very polite. Oh my god, that kid still hasn't come back after he fled after I accidentally whacked him with a staff. Might have traumatized him. I feel a little bad about that. Mistakes were made. Alright. Oh, hey! Quest giver! No, don't talk to me. No, talk. There we go.
I'd craft dressings for the wounded had I the makings. If only I'd known. Cuz I need a favor. Can you fetch the flowers I need from outside the village? I need more of the one you see there. And one other sort besides. The more you can find, the better.
Available quest changes as you progress through the game. Additionally, you can always consult the quest section of the pause menu for your current objectives. People with red icons appearing above their heads have information relevant to your priority quests. If you have several quests going at the same time, you can set one as priority in the quest section of the pause menu. Doing so will make all people, places, and things relevant to the priority quest appear prominently on the minimap. That's pretty handy.
The wounded need medicine, cousin. Pray bring the flowers for the compound quick as you can. The mixture calls for two types of flowers. Speak to the others for more word on that. I ask you this favor because I trust you, good Fisher. I know you'll not leave these people to suffer.
So, wait, you want me to bring these herbs because you need my help, so these people are suffering. These people are in terrible shape, except you're not actually going to tell me what they are. Alright, so I need pink flowers and something else. Thanks for that really detailed quest explanation. These people are suffering. Figure out what to do on your own. Thanks. Hello.
Oh, Benita has you picking flowers for her. Pray, just be cautious, cousin. The monsters grow bolder by night. If you must leave the village, go prepared. I do not fancy the thought of you going off on your own. But I trust in your judgment.
Well, that makes one of us.
If you come by the inn, you can always rest until the hour you wish to set out. In any case, take care. What can I do you for?
Never mind. See, it said the red marks mean he has something to say relevant to my quest, but I don't see how that was all that relevant. I have no idea what my carrying capacity is. So I'm just gonna keep picking shit up, I guess, until it tells me to knock it off. As usual. Anyone want to take any bets on how much of this game I spend over-encumbered? Spoiler alert, smart money is on most of it. Alright, anything else to see in here? Alright, just leads around back to here. Head out the entrance. Purchase equipment and useful items from shops or wandering merchants you encounter on your travels. You can restore health and stamina and advance the passage of time at any inn or resting spot. Okie dokie. Let's check out my inventory. Let's see what all this crap is. So nuts. So, alright, so all of these restore health in some way, shape, or form. And over here is how much my carrying weight is. And so right now I'm doing pretty good on carrying weight. Let's see. Tools. All right, I've got a lantern. A gaily decorated pie favored by actors and jesters, meant for throwing, not eating. All right. Simple container that might be thrown to make noise. Or does that mean there's going to be stealth sections or something? A deadly throwing knife. All right. Materials. Cloud wine, hemp, and Grancis herb. Interesting. Blank scroll, buckets, and brooms. Weapons, all I've got is the rusted staff. Oh, I thought it was wood. Wow, that is some really ugly, staff then. Or metal. Alright, so. Plebeian shirt offers little protection against the cold, but little else. And fisherman's tatters. It looks like I'm wearing the plebeian shirt, so not sure why I'd want to wear the other thing. Cloth greaves? Yeah, those look terrible. Alright, that's pretty much it. So I don't actually know how to craft anything or anything like that yet, so we're gonna stick with that. Join me for a drink. You can raise your affinity with people by giving them items or completing the quests they ask of you. Performing actions that people dislike will decrease their affinity for you. Oh, so I probably decreased affinity by hitting those people back there. No, talk to me.
She's back. Make her be praised she's back. The alehouse is open once more.
Well, he's already over the whole dragon thing. Good for him. Why do people keep getting spooked when I walk up to him?
Gathering ingredients, eh? You often see those flowers growing at the roots of bigger trees. Not that I'm fain to brave the roads these days. Just see you're not injured yourself, good fisher.
I suspect the old English is going to grate after a while. Hopefully not before too long.
Up to your old mischief, Minnow. If you've time to gad about, make yourself useful. We all knew the dragon was coming. The faith can keep their prophecies. The dragon always comes around, sure as the seasons.
Is that just a regular event? Dragon showing up and murdering everybody? That's a little odd.
Fate mocks me. I thought to run, even made a start of it. Yet here I am again.
Weird. Where's my mini-map? Shouldn't I have a mini-map or something? After accepting a quest, first note the quest marker on your map, then continue by searching for required items or information. Quest markers will vary based on time, location, and your target's actions. If you've come to an impasse in one quest, why not try progressing through another? You may find a solution to your initial problem. Sounds good to me. Alright. I thought there was an option or something to show minimap somewhere. Yeah, minimap display is on. I don't seem to have one, though. Select options from the pause menu to customize your minimap and status display. I just did. Where's my minimap?
It's a mercy so much the village was spared. I only wish I had more to offer.
Chicken stroganoff. That sounds nice. Zero. Alright, so I can buy from here. I don't see if there's a way to sell. I can mine ore? I don't know if that's a thing I want to do. I've got a decent amount of gold, but I think I'm going to save it until I know what the hell I need to do with my gold. Got some arrows, throwables. Alright, some weapons. I can get a better staff. Alright, so that underneath where it says total is showing me what classes can use the staff. See, I could get a better staff. Strength 11, magic 52. I have no idea what my current one is. Oh, no, it's right there. Alright, so that's... Alright, so that looks like a decent step up from what I have. That ironclad staff is only a small step up, so maybe I could get into that. But I don't have any armor either. Maybe I should look into that a little bit. Oh, geez, these are both terrible. They make me look so hideous. Look at those hats. Terrible, man. Do I want to turn down a hat just because it makes me look hideous? Kind of. Alright, elemental resistances or debilitation resistances? Those are nice. So again, I don't know if I want to be doing my stuff at the store or if I want to find items. You know, some games you don't want to be doing a lot of shopping in. But I think as a ranged character, I'm going to want to have a good weapon as soon as possible. Let me go ahead and pick up one of these. And yeah, I'll equip that right away. And that is a pretty sizable jump up, it looks like. Especially in magic.
I only wish I had more to offer.
So we'll see how noticeable that is once I get out into the world and actually start fighting some dudes. Hard to tell in the meantime. Steal all the things. Ooh, an apple, nice. Probably. Oh, I can't take the gravy boat. Screw your gravy boat, then. See, I'm just picking up buckets and brooms, and I have no idea if I'm actually going to need them at some point. I can't even imagine why. Hopefully I'll be able to sell them, maybe? Sell them off, get a whole bunch of money. One would hope. Alright, Oh, those are supposed to be your wares, I suppose. Can't just steal all those. That'd be nice, though, I suppose. Alright, so this will be a food store, so I don't think I need to hit that up yet, because I've been stealing all the food I need from everyone around. I think I was just there, the fisherman's house. Am I heading backwards or something? No. Town just has an odd layout. Or maybe it's just... Oh, alright, so just all the townspeople are fishermen. Hello. Alright. So I got I had to gather instead of just pick up, but I got some blank scrolls out of that. Do I need blank scrolls? I don't know. Well, I guess we'll find out. Alright, so you'll notice one thing that's nice is once I go into some of these locations, it's actually adding marks to my map. So there is a good point for going into all these buildings. Because I'm getting some nice... getting some nice additions to my map, which I'm sure I'll be happy for later. Alright. In here, anything? Flask of oil, sure, I'll take that. So yeah, it's a little bit of a slow start, but I'm sure once I leave this village, it's going to be pretty much all combat all the time until I can get to the next village. As, you know, most RPGs happen to work. I will continue to mention this throughout the stream, but I hope everyone is having a good holiday this weekend. Now, of course, there's lots of different ways to have a good holiday. Maybe you're spending it with family, maybe you're spending it with friends. Maybe you're just having something nice to eat. Maybe you're exchanging gifts with someone. Or hell, maybe you're just playing some good video games that you picked up in the Steam sale. Or one of the other various gaming site sales around there. Whatever works. Whatever works for you.
Gathering ingredients, eh? You often see those...
Oh, no, I already talked to him. Alright, oh, hey, there's a stone over here. Check that out. Hello. Oh, I guess I can't use it yet. Well, that's lame. I want some pawns. Or, oh, I suppose my character doesn't know what a pawn is yet. You're not spending 'cause no money? Aw. Well, I know for a fact you got to spend the weekend with your lady, so that works 2-0. Like I said, there's lots of different ways to have a good holiday, and as long as you're doing something, as long as you're doing something that makes you happy, that's all that matters. Now, I personally spent way too much, because that is my way. This is actually one of the things I picked up in the Steam sale just a couple days ago. I didn't expect to be playing it so quickly. Oh, that 2-0. If that is a thing that makes you happy, that works. Oop, no. Take the ladder. Take the ladder. Ladders are a little tricky to get on, apparently. Anything else I need to explore around here? I want to make sure I got all the marks added to my map that I'm going to need. Oh, hey. Can grab onto stuff there. That's cool. And a chest? So what did we just learn here, folks? Exploration is a good thing. Duly noted. Alright, so that's cool. So I wasn't actually sure if I'd be able to find anything interesting up here, but yeah, it would appear so. So let's check around a little bit more. Let me know we can jump up on stuff. Not going to call it a game changer, but that's interesting. Assassin's Creed 0.6. Oh, man. I do like me some Assassin's Creed games. I haven't played a lot of them yet, but I played halfway through the first one and then gave up where a lot of people give up, which is where the assassination started repeating. Hello? Oh, I guess I walked too close to the gate and triggered something. I think I'm tripping balls, dudes. Whoa! Hey, bro. That's a nice glowy hand you got right there. The what now?
They come from some unknown place. Just appear without a warning. They are a strange lot.
That is video games as hell.
Not human, quite. They look the part, sure enough, but they lack the will, the spark, what drives us.
So, like, they're actual in-universe NPCs, I suppose.
They have no capacity to feel nor act alone. So they live as sellswords. Myrmidons, they're called. There's an encampment west of the village where men gather to face the dragon. I'd wager a fair number of his kind will be there as well. Why don't you take him? Might be you learn aught of why he came to you in the first place.
Before leaving, visit the store to make sure you've ample supplies.
Truly know what the Arisen is meant to do, 'tis likely best to follow the pawn's lead. Alright, so I've got a pawn.
Purchasing equipment here in Cassidus will make for a safer trip to the encampment.
Alright, so I guess after this I do have to leave, so yeah, I should probably buy a couple things. Yeah, Samwise, he does? Yeah, I've got myself a Samwise. The universe teleported me a Samwise. Go figure.
West to the encampment, no doubt. Why don't you see him there? His kind'll rot where they stand, unless a human orders them to move.
That's weird. He's not a pawn, he's a rook. Well, yeah. This is true. Alright, so let's hit up the shop.
If he's landed any further inland, this shop will be flat as a plank now. Makes me ill just to think of it.
Her accent does not at all fit the other characters. Alright, I can sell stuff, it looks like. I have no idea if there's anything I want to keep, if there's anything I want to sell. I don't know. I'll sell this. Certainly. We'll do that. Yeah, I don't think there's anything else I necessarily want to sell until I can figure out what the hell everything does. So yeah, we'll just stick with that. Let's see. Now? Alright, how do I... Yes, there we go. Alright, cool, got a little money for that, so now we go back to the buy menu. And let's get some gear, I suppose. Got a weapon, let's get a stupid hat. Now let's start to... See, it doesn't have any jewelry. Cloaks! Those are kind of pricey, I can't afford those. I've got leg armor. Funny bone guards! It's kind of cute. I think I'll get these talismanic beads for right now. It's only a little protection, but a little, what is that, bleeding maybe? It's cheap anyway. I'll just pick it up and then I'll be good there. Cool. And I'll go ahead and equip that immediately. Not jewelry. Where is it, arms? Yeah, here we go. Equip. Good deal. What else we got going on here? Alright, yeah, I gotta get one of the hats. And I'll get the leather cap because it's slightly less stupid. Plus, it looks like it works on any class, so that'll be nice. Alright. There's my stupid hat. Good job. Alright, I think that's all I'm going to want for now. So let's head out and get where we're going, I suppose. Is there a shortcut to get to the map? I don't think so, unfortunately. Man, that's as zoomed out as it goes as well. Nope. Scroll the map with the arrow keys? Or I can just scroll to the edge of the map. There we go. Kind of. Maybe. Alright, so... Yeah, I feel like I've probably explored pretty much everything worth exploring in the village. So let's go ahead and head out the front gate. Man, he is a chatty Cathy. Let's head down this way. I think the gate was down here. Alright, so within towns I can dash for free, so that is nice for getting around. Alright, so first order of business is to see if I can hunt down those flowers.
The encampment. This path should see us there.
This game has an autosave function, periodically will autosave my progress. Can also manually save any time by pressing I in the pause menu. Hey, don't get too far, buddy. I gotta find flowers first. Where? Where's Goblin? Is there a Goblin? The hell is there a Goblin? I hear a Goblin, I don't see a Goblin. Oh, there he is. Ooh. As you take damage, the amount of health you can recover through magic in the field also decreases, indicated by a white bar. Rest at an inn or use curative items to fully recover your health. Alright. So, basically damage hurts my max health, too, until I rest at an inn or use items. Giving pawns curatives to hold will allow them to use at their own discretion. Good deal. Alright, so there we go. He's down. Let's go ahead and pick up the rest of the stuff over here. Oh, thanks, buddy. To receive the effects of curative magic, step within the area of healing light. Alright, good deal. And I think these are the flowers I need. Yeah, wow. He's just all about these side quests. Oh, hey, Al. Welcome to the stream and happy holidays. I'm going to pick that up again tomorrow, but I wanted to play something a little special for Christmas. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to play this today. I'm going to play Mirror's Edge tomorrow. And then after that, I'm going to pick this back up again and finish it. Alright, cool. That killed him pretty fast. And a Rift Fragment. Alright, good deal. I don't know what that is, but that sounds cool. So yeah, today, Dragon's Dogma Dark Arisen. Tomorrow, we finish Mirror's Edge. Then after that, we go back to Dragon's Dogma, and we're going to finish it off. Hopefully that sounds like a good plan. What the? He's getting his ass kicked. Where the hell is he? Down here? Oh, thanks for teaching me how to attack, game. I think I had that under control, actually. Yeah, let's go ahead and set these dudes on fire. They don't appear to like that. And I do like killing from a distance. Thought it might have froze again? No, it seems to be working okay for me. Stream looks okay from my end, too. Yeah, I'd like to think so. Sorry about hitting you with fire a whole bunch in there. When foes seem too much to handle, try gaining levels or obtaining better equipment.
This looks interesting.
Oh, that was far too close. I'm called Reynard, a traveling salesman, though those damnable beasts ruined my wares.
Oops.
But thanks to you, it was only wares I lost. I'll consider it a bargain. Have my thanks.
Alright, that works.
What's that?
Pawns will collect and use items of their own volition. So that's what he's doing, is going around picking up items. You may see peddlers hawking their wares as you make your way around Grancis, which I assume is this world. They often come across rare items not found at more stationary shops. If you see a peddler, make sure to check what they have to offer. Sounds good to me. Alright, so that rock, I assume, is one of the ore things they talked about before. Alright, yeah, let's go find some trees, then. See if we can find some more of those flowers we need for the quest. So how's your holiday going so far, Al? You have a good weekend so far? I hope so. This is going to be an extra long stream as well. Because I wanted to be around for Christmas, in case anybody needed some entertainment today. It's a pretty big flower you're using as a weapon. No! It's a staff. Mighty staff. Mighty weapon of mighty mages. And as you can see, it's the slayer of rabbits. Die, rabbit. Just beating rabbits to death, as mighty heroes often do. Now this one. I don't even know if I need rabbit pelts. But just in case. I'm getting a tiny bit of experience too, so. You know, gotta beat them rabbits up. PETA can come get some, Zero. Oh, hey, chest, just. Don't overdo it. I wonder what's inside. Sweet. Money. Wow. See, I can hear him, but I still can't see him. Oh, here he is. He got awfully close. Alright, and he's toast. Good deal. I guess. So I guess goblins don't show up on the mini-map, unfortunately, because I didn't see him till he was right on top of me. A wealth of useful items can be found by vanquishing monsters or exploring the environment. Keep your eyes peeled. Okie dokie. Kindling. I thought there was going to hit mushrooms from this, but alright, kindling works too. Sure look like mushrooms. Can be used at shops or other locations to enhance your equipment. Alright, so I didn't see an option to enhance or anything in that shop we were at. Maybe there's shops later on that'll offer some sort of enhancement options. Yeah, I gotcha. Still don't think I have enough flowers for that side quest. I haven't seen any more aside from by that one tree. I guess that's the encampment up ahead, since it's the only thing the road leads to. This road will have us to the encampment here much longer. I heard some people mention that they turned off pawn chatter because they got pretty annoying, and I think I see why. Poison arrows? That sounds nice. What are these? I think they're explodey barrels, so I'm not going to mess with them too much up close. Oh, why did you do that? Oh my god. So, in addition to being mindless, they're kind of idiots, it looks like. Alright, so I got him where he wanted to go. It's not a pawn, it's a rook. I'm just going by what they're telling me, Zero. I can't do any more than that. Alright, well, it mentioned that the flower only blooms during the daytime, so I suppose we may as well head into the encampment for right now. Nice table flip, though, Zero. Yes?
I know the way, Master. Follow me.
Somebody was talking to me right there. That's weird. Alright, I'm going. Thought he was supposed to be my pawn. Just use the guy's name. He's nobody, Zero. He's nobody. Alright, well. There's one of those stones. Command headquarters.
Have all you need? We are an inn first and foremost, but we offer more than simple lodging. We can safeguard your belongings or aid in learning new skills. Have your pick, any you like.
Learn or set skills. Sounds interesting. Spending discipline. I have no idea how discipline is spent or is acquired, so I want to be careful spending it. There's thunder, lightning, fire, ice. Oh, so that's self-centered. That's pretty cool. It does sound nice. Core skills, augments, secret augments. Discipline is spent using an item called whip. Oh, jeez. That's going to make things a little weird. Just a little weird. Let's see. Kind of like the idea of that. I'm just not sure whether that's spending just like a shitload of discipline or not. Let's see. Oh, right, I do have that healing ability. I need to start using that to try it out.
What will it be today? Have your pick, any you like.
Alright, so I'm good for right now. So let's go ahead and check out that stone that pawn was interested in. Discipline points can be spent to learn useful augments and skills. Skills and augments must be enabled in order to make use of them. But where do I get discipline from?
Excellent!
Whoa! That was timed so perfectly. It was timed right when I hit the stone. And I'm like, holy crap, that stone is screaming at me. Whip it good. Oh, thank you for the donation, Anonymous. Oh my god, that was hysterical. Well, since it's anonymous, I'm going to assume it was from the Big Rock right there. Thank you, Big Rock, for donating $5 and for screaming at me right there. And Zero, appreciate the spam right there. Holy crap. Whew. Oh, jeez. Oh, that legit scared the crap out of me. Fantastic. You know, some people actually have things that are meant to scare them as their sounds, but not me. They just incidentally scare the crap out of me. But that is amazing. Thank you so much for that donation, Anonymous. I appreciate it so much. Every little bit does a lot to help out the stream. For example, that $5 will probably be gone within the next 24 hours into the Steam sale for more stream games. So good deal. Thank you. Thank you so much. All right, but let's continue. What? What? Right as I get back into the big rock for Britain. What is happening in this stream tonight? Big rock for president. Oh my god. Thank you for another $5. Anonymous. Anonymous, clearly you are a big fan of this rock. Got some rock fans in here tonight. Good deal. Thank you so much. I was just talking about how I'm going to make good use of that. I'm going to spend the crap out of that on the Steam sale. You watch. I'll post in Discord about it later. What horrible crap I'm buying on the Steam sale for the stream. But thank you. Thank you on behalf of me and everyone else that is going to enjoy all the Steam games we're going to be playing for that. That is so great. Thank you. That's fantastic. Oh, see, the rock at least understands it's a little awkward for me talking to a rock here. Especially since it's screaming at me with electric guitars. I am still supporting Big Rock for president, though. Don't you worry, Big Rock. You and me going places. Zero, thank you for backing me up there. I appreciate it, buddy.
This rift serves as a gate. It connects our kind to your world. It opens to the Arisen, for they possess a will powerful enough to guide the Legion.
Radio, what did you walk into? You walked into a rock screaming at me and throwing money at me. Big rock for president, what? Look, I think it'd be a good candidate right there. It's solid. It's steadfast. It's got the benefits of age. Sturdy. Well-worn. I can make rock puns all day and all night. I will do so if necessary. But yes, you walked into someone very nice donating to the stream, and that is amazing. Full of arcane knowledge, apparently. Gateway to the Pawn Legion.
If you would claim to be among the Arisen, prove the strength of your resolve.
Somebody told me I'm Arisen, and I kind of like the idea of having a title, so sure.
Very well. Then we shall guide you in your trial. If you are an Arisen in truth, this humble task will prove no obstacle. The Arisen must possess the valor to stand against all threats.
The power to quell. 10 out of 10. See, I was all on board with this rock, and now this rock's like, are you a bad enough dude to save the president? All I wanted to do was look at this rock, and now it's like, hey, are you sure you're hero enough to be a hero? The rock's not actually talking. The rock is a portal to someone who's talking to me, I think. It's a portal to the Pawn Legions, who are literally in-universe NPCs. They're non-humans that look like humans, except they don't... I thought maybe the stream froze and I was hallucinating. No, this is... I already went to bed and left the stream running. This is the voice of the rock. The pawns in here are actually... like, in-universe NPCs, they're mindless, will-less, human-looking non-humans that just follow you around and do stuff for you. Which is very convenient in a video game, let me tell you.
A tireless spirit of self-improvement grants the strength to lead the Legion.
There you go, Zero. So many things can be learned from the wisdom of Zelda. Search the area. Well, that's a simple quest. Details on my current condition. Do I have a current condition? No, it doesn't look like it. I'm level 3, though. That's kind of cool. No current condition. Oh, poison resistance is what I had before. All right, that's cool, then. Let me ask everybody again. How is the volume of the in-game stuff? It'll be able to easier to tell once I get into a fight, but you'll see in a second. I am wearing a tiny hat. The The other hat choice was actually stupider than this one. And you know how it is in a video game, you have to take the thing that is the good armor. And so in this case, the good armor that I could afford right now is this stupid ass hat. Alright, no, seriously, what is this quest I'm on right now? They want me to search the area? Set one as your priority quest. Pawns in your party will also offer advice for the priority quest more than other quests in your log. Alright, so yeah, I still need some more flowers for that. Check the area around the encampment until you find a threat that must be quelled. I'll set that as priority. Alright, so I didn't even get to check anything around the encampment, and now they immediately want me to leave the encampment. That's handy. It looks like you have an oblong head and your skull is poking out. Kinda does. Especially from the side in the dark, doesn't it? Like I just shaved my head off and then just kept shaving until I took all the skin out, didn't I? Well, that's grotesque. No, I can guarantee you I did not do that thing. It is actually, it's a little tiny Robin Hood hat is what it is. I don't have any idea whether that actually has a name or not. Probably. But I just always call them Robin Hood hats. The beast comes. Hurry. Is this the thing that the magic rock voice was telling me about? Presumably. Alright, well I got a quest marker now, so let's head towards that. There may be prowling monsters about. Yeah, thanks, Rook. Alright, let's check through here, it looks like. The legendary Kappa monster. Oh man, I do look like a Kappa, don't I? You got the terrible hair for it, too. Oh, hey! That's a huge mon- Wow, what the hell is that thing? Oh, jeez! Yeah, just turn it off with the big lever switch I have, obviously. Alright, so this is a big old bastard. Well, you keep your distance, big guy. I'm gonna kill you from back here if you don't mind. He seems to be getting stuck on those walls there, so that's making things easier. Some people just like to Alt F4 when they get salty. Who are these people? And how can I avoid meeting them for the rest of my life? That sounds like a horrible person. I mean, like, I've definitely heard of people that, like, in mid-online game, they'll rage quit to avoid affecting their score or something, which is also terrible. But, yeah, when I see that right there, that's what I think of when you talk about people just quitting mid-game. It's like, who even... Are they worried about people just, like, reaching around their computer and hitting the switch back there? The power supply switch? Just slamming it off or just yanking the cord? Yeah, that was mostly me. I'm gonna take most of the credit for that one. Uh-oh. Mysterious hooded figure. Now we got an RPG. Was it? I'm still at full health. I felt like that wasn't too hard. Beast steak! Yes! Kill a beast, get a steak! What's that? Now we're talking. Alright, I see things on the map. Head back into the encampment, see what it wants me to do next. Treat others well, and they shall treat you well in kind. Is that a tooltip for the game, or just in general? And heal my pawn, I think. Heal him? Maybe? I think? Couldn't tell if that actually healed him or not. How do I heal this dude? No, it doesn't actually seem to be healing him any. Should really figure out how to get the healing working. I don't know, it sure looks like it should be working. Maybe it's his max health, and I have to stay at an inn now. That's possible. Your character had no sense of urgency, just standing there like he was feeding bread to ducks. That's how mages work, man! Oh, there's a monster. I'm gonna stand over here and shoot fireballs at it till it dies. Unless it's coming right at me, unless it can actually lay hands on me, it's not really a legitimate threat, it's just target practice. Mage stuff. Ekbal, located in the command headquarters of the encampment, provides many different support functions to adventurers. Speak with him to rest and heal your wounds, learn or enable useful weapon skills, or store excess items. Alright, first of all, I got a rock to talk to. Hey, rock. A strange power emanates from within. That was actually a pretty cool effect.
With that, your trial is complete.
Oh, that was easy.
You are the Arisen in truth. Proven beyond any doubt.
Hell yeah.
Now, I bid you select a companion for the journey ahead.
Okie dokie.
They shall serve you and you alone. To share in your hardships and aid you in every endeavor.
Oh god, next time I play D&D, I'm totally going to name a character Ekbal the Shed. That is amazing. That is amazing. Ho, weary travelers, let us travel together. My name is Ekbal the Shed. Why were you named that, Ekbal? Shut up. Shut up. Alright, so now I get to pick a pawn for realsies. Pawn customization. Set the look of your constant companion throughout your journey as Arisen, your main pawn. So let's get a lady pawn to offset my dudeness. Yeah, let's do that. Please enter a name. What am I naming my pawn here, folks? Somebody throw out some suggestions. I need a name. From what I understand, this will be my pawn through the entire game, so it needs to be a good name. This will be my follower, who helps me fight, helps me heal, carries around my stuff, gives irritating commentary constantly. I am really bad with names, so I always need help for parts like this. I guess I could go with a chess theme if I wanted to, maybe, since they're pawns and rooks, but that might be taken later on in the game. All I can think of right now is Ekbal the Shed. It's just taking up everything in my head. But Ekbal's the guy right outside. I don't want to name her after that. What do we want to name her? So any suggestions? I've kind of got one that I'm starting to think of, but if anyone has any ideas, I'll take them as well. What I'm thinking is... Yeah, usually if I... Irish Space Tiger? I don't think that's a good tigress! You might be onto something there. Tigress. Tigress sounds like something from Thundercats. Tuna Pilgrim! You know what? Sure, let's call her Tuna. Tuna's a name. Let's call her Tuna. Shady's Games and his loyal pawn, Tuna. Sure! Alright, so now I have to pick a moniker, which is a name for people that have parental controls on, and for which the idea of seeing a character named Tuna is maybe too much for them. In which case, we'll call her Tammy. Tammy Tuna. Sure. Let's roll with it. All right. Now we pick the look of our pawn. Let's see. Now, keep in mind, I don't think she'll actually be wearing the clothing items here. Tammy Tuna. Jesus Christ. That's how we're rolling here. Alright, so I think the clothing on these characters is changeable. Right now, we're just looking at body types. Oh, jeez. Who do we want for Tammy 2 now? I'm kind of inclined for this Amazon at the end. That'd be pretty badass. Who do we want to go with? The actual child right there. No, I'm not going to bring an actual child around a tank for me. That's just crazy town. Viking lady. This one right there, that's what I'm thinking too. Now, like I said, the equipment I think is changeable. So this is just, we're picking the body type. But I think this one is who I want to go to. She looks like a badass. And I do want a badass following me around. Yeah, let's go with her. Let's do that. Now, let's pick a voice. Tammy Toon of the Titan! Yes, the legend begins! This voice sounds pretty Zarya. Let's give her a Zarya voice, shall we? Since she's already a Titan. Alright, Tammy Tuna. I think we're good. Pick the highest pitched one? No! No! But we'll give her the Zarya voice. Because that fits. See, I was thinking about picking a ridiculous voice for my main character, but then I'm like, oh my god. That would get so irritating so fast. And if this is going to be like a 40-hour game, I'd get sick of it pretty quick. So let's not do that. Yeah, we're going with this. This will be the form of your main pawn. Proceed. Yeah, Tammy. Tammy, we're doing it. You'll be asked a few questions. Your answers will shape your pawn's inclination. Okay. When faced with danger, what trait would you most value in a follower? I don't know what half of these name is. What the heck is a scather? Do I want a pawn inclination to be Nexus? What does that even mean? Iron Will? Sure. When in battle, what strategy would you prefer your follower to employ? Rescue comrades in danger, I suppose. Whoa, what? Oh, you just noticed the easy listening music in the background? Yeah, I guess I've been talking over it, but yeah, when we create our pawns, we get nice elevator music. Your follower rescues your party and turns the tide of the entire battle. What would you have them say? This is really weird. I have no idea what any of these are affecting. Sure. As a ruler, what gift would please you most? You notice these still all change the stats of all these bars over there. That's just weird. Brave and just hero to succeed me. Select a vocation. Since I'm a mage, we are going to make Tammy Tuna a fighter. So that she can tank for me while I attack from a distance. I think that's going to be my best option. I believe we can change vocation later on. But right now, yeah, fighter's going to be best. And knowing me, I'm probably going to be taking mostly ranged vocations myself, so I think a fighter is probably going to complement me pretty well. Alright. Pawn created. Let's see her. In the flesh. Hey, Tammy. Nice glowy hand.
Our fealty is sworn to you, Arisen. From this day, the Legion's men call pawns live and die by your command.
Alright, cool. Good deal. Oh, yeah, if you guys want to bow too, that'd be cool. Go ahead and go with your feelings there. I can force you, but, you know, if it feels right, make it happen. Having been recognized as Arisen, you have been granted a loyal pawn to be your constant companion in your journey. Hey, Tammy. In addition to this main pawn, you may hire up to 2 other pawns to support you in your adventures. Different pawns have different strengths, so use support pawns to tailor your party to fit your current needs. In addition to mining level and available skills, a pawn's knowledge is another important part of creating an effective party. Pawns with appropriate knowledge of quests or foes can provide helpful advice and battle strategies. Alright, and Tammy just got a level too. God damn it, you should have named her Barbariana. Well, too late now. Tammy Tuna it is. Hey, Tammy. Just...
A strange power emanates from within.
Her voice.
A master in his pawn, is it?
Hell yeah, dude.
You'll be quite the force come the day you learn to fight as one.
You challenging me? You want to go?
Mind you, that is a skill better honed in practice than in the heat of mortal combat.
Fight me. 1v1 me, scrub.
I can help in that regard, should you wish it.
Yeah, sure, I'll cave your skull in if you're that eager for it. Bring it. What do you got? Put you down right here, right now, in front of all your buddies. Uh-oh. Uh-oh. You know what he's doing? Waiting for the main plot to kick in. Don't worry, I'll get to you soon enough. In time.
Ready to begin. Are you?
It, you? What? It's you lurking in the hood.
Let me be clear from the outset. I'm a harsh master, whoever the pupil.
And I am a giant asshole that will make fun of you at every turn.
You'll complete 3 forms of training in sequence.
The Harvester wannabe. Oh god, there's a game right there. Freaking Harvester.
If you find a task too difficult to manage, you might reconsider your party.
Alright.
There are other pawns here. You can choose among them if you care to.
Cool.
The first task is carrying freight. Haul the lot of them before my count ends.
Harvester might be fun on stream, but one of the problems is, if you remember, when you and me played at radio, it skipped a whole bunch of the cinemas, which apparently is some sort of CPU timing problem. And there is a fix to it, but it's very fiddly and depends on your individual CPU. So before I can play Harvester on stream, I want to be really damn sure it's not going to skip all the cinemas, because if so, the game really is only half as weird. So once I decide to play around with that, we'll see. But yeah, Harvester would be a fun stream game. Alright, so this guy wants me to haul his shit, so I'm not sure if this is training or he just has shit that needs to be hauled.
You're free to choose your company, but this is a task too great for just one person.
Because it's a mighty epic hauling task.
Many hands lighten any load, as they say. Now, get to it. We'll begin as soon as you're prepared. Just give the word. Then be off. I'll be here when you're ready to train.
You can judge the suitability of your party based on that information.
Alright, so I think I can grab another... Where the hell am I? I think I can grab one more pawn as well, so that might be handy. No, seriously, where the hell did he take me? Alright, so I seem to be in the middle of nowhere? Sure. Alright, let's go ahead and do this then.
We'll begin. Your task is to haul all of the freight before my count ends. Get to it.
The fantasy version of two guys in a truck. What a mighty challenge. All the way up there. What? Well, that's why he wanted me to haul his shit, because it's all the way up there. Alright, so bring those boxes to wherever he needs them brought to, I guess. Alright, get this one right here first. Oh, how do I grab it? They seem to be hauling it for me, which is good, because I can't seem to figure out how to pick it up. What is the deadline? I don't even see a counter on screen. Yeah, you guys keep working on that. You seem to be doing a great job at it. Leave it to you folks. Good job. Haul the stuff. Haul all of the stuff. They get all of it? Enough. Did they do it?
Well done. Ah! Each challenge with that vigor, and you'll make for a fine warrior afore long.
So this is the first important quality today in Shading's games. I can't pick up a box. Clearly the first essential quality of an Arisen is they must be able to run around confused while their pawns do all the important shit for them. And in that, I have passed with flying colors. I hope I get a badge or something, the running around confused while pawns do shit for you badge. I think that'll really push my look up to the next level. Fits well with my exposed skull cap up there.
Next is combat training. You'll face my scarecrow army here. Destroy them before my count ends.
You want me to burn things? That I can do. Sure, whatever. That last one is easy enough.
Destroying scarecrows this time. Get them all before my count ends.
Yeah, I bet it's gonna be really hard. Bet it's gonna be really hard.
I'll fill it with a spell.
Oh no, it's looking really hard. Oh, there's more, alright. That's okay. I'm super duper ranged, so whatever. Is there more? I hear him hitting something. Oh, there's some up there, alright. Maybe? No. I guess they took down the last couple of it. More running around confused. I'm great at this! Training so hard, I'm just barely muddling through with all of my skills.
Each with its own weakness. One falls only to steel and brute force, the other only to magic. If you're not mindful of how you attack them, you'll fail. Strike fast and strike hard.
He's actually maybe making a challenge for me.
Vary your party and your tactics until you find success. We'll begin? Well,
sure.
It's back to the scarecrows for your last attack.
Seriously, what is his count? I don't actually see a count anywhere. Alright, so that's one of the magic ones. That's a magic one. That one's not. That one's not. That one's not. Alright, yeah, she's gotten those taken care of. So how about this one? This one is... There we go. Vocation rank increased. Yay.
Enough!
He's so excited when he says that.
It will come in time. For now.
Oh, no, I didn't do it in time. Boo. So I mentioned something about switching pawns, so how do I do that? I seem to be trapped in this tiny little area with him. I guess I can leave, then. Alright, I'll come back to the training grounds after I swap out pawns, then.
I feel familiar with this area now.
Disclosed. Seems we need dispensation to pass.
It's horribly, horribly difficult training of mine. Oh my god, they are so chatty back there. I may seriously have to turn that off. That is insane. Alright. So let's see how this works. This is a rift, a space between realms from which any and all manner of pawns may be found. Should one catch your eye, speak with the pawn and enlist it to your party. Alright, I kind of want a ranged pawn. Like this guy in the belly shirt.
Yes, Arisen.
Oh, alright. Alright, so that's a free enlist, I think. Let's check out the details. Alright, so it doesn't have much of a vocation. But, level 4? Sure. Yeah, let's grab this one. So the way this works from my understanding is I've got my permanent pawn, Tammy Tuna, and then I can get two other pawns that I can swap out as need be. And many of these pawns are actually going to be clones of other players that have played or are playing Dragon's Dogma, so that's pretty cool. Alright, how do I get back out of the rift now? Go back to the stone. Touching the stone allows you to seek and summon pawns or return to your realm. Alright. Exit the rift. Cool. Alright, so now I've got 3 pawns. One from each of the 3 classes. So that's cool. Let's see if that helps me out a little bit more in the challenge now. Where is that training camp? So chatty, wow! Which one's the training camp? This one? This one's the training grounds, I think. Alright, let's try again for Scarecrow Murder. It's gonna be really important. We really need to know how to kill those scarecrows quickly. Alright, here we go. Alright, cool. Got that one. Nope, this one. Here we go. Alright. How about this one? Alright, that one just sort of fell over. That's weird. Alright, there's one up there. Did we do it? Yeah! So clearly, the secret to Scarecrow Massacre is bring a bunch of dudes to help you do it.
Well done! You've completed your training. See now the difference well-selected partners can make. Yes, no doubt.
If by well-selected you mean lots of them.
You'll learn the rest from actual combat. If you have trouble, examine your party.
If your strategies seem toothless against your foes, try changing your party makeup, enabled skills, and equipment.
I've learned what to do in this quest.
Nice. Alright, and Tammy Tuna leveled up. Good deal.
The training grounds are used to his foes.
Seems we need dispensation to pass.
Alright, let's see what this guy has to say. I don't remember what color green is as far as quests go.
I've heard talk of the Arisen. They say you hold dominion over the pawns.
Hell yeah.
I've ordered pawns to take up swords and fight myself. But they are a clumsy lot.
That's mean.
I cannot call them into this world as you do, though. Nor make traveling companions of them. What manner of magic lets you command them so?
I'm the PC.
Well, it matters not. A dragon is come. I'll welcome any help. Be it pawn, Arisen, farmer or fishwife. Make use of the encampment as you please. Are you in need of rest?
No, I'm good.
Well, come again whenever you time.
Alright, so apparently green is something or whatever. She wasn't tremendously helpful with anything. Alright, so let's check around the camp a little bit more and see if we can spot anything else of interest around here. And then we will head out in a bit. Alright, so, let's see, learn or set skills. What skills can I learn now? Anything new? Or just those 5? But I have gotten a crap load more discipline right now, so that's cool. Oh, levitate. Hello. Mitigates gravity's pull, enabling a gentle landing even from great heights. Ooh, I like that, but it costs a lot. Equanimity. There we go. Equanimity. Struggling there. Amplifies your magic when you stand at death's door. Alright, so take enough damage, get stronger magic. Reduces cumulative damage when you are debilitated by the five arch magics. Alright, so take magic debilitation, get stronger. Secret augments. Can't learn any of those, so for now, let me grab this, because that sounds cool. Doesn't cost too much. And let me see how I can set that. Change my enabled skills, yes. Alright, let's set it right there, shall we? Alright, cool. So that'll be my new right-click skill, and that'll help me out in melee, I suspect. So it looks like I can basically have up to six skills equipped at any given time. That's cool. Alright, let's confirm that. Oops, nope. That didn't work. Alright. And then we just back out.
What will it be today? Have your pick, any you like.
I don't think I need to rest, but I'll check my pawns in a second. Core skills are enabled as soon as they are learned. Don't forget to enable skills and augments for your main pawn as well. Ooh, how do I do that? I have no idea. How do I do anything with my main pawn? Oh, here we go. Blink, strike, and shield summons. I have no idea what any of those are. She doesn't have... Well, she's never fought any enemies, I suppose. That makes sense. She doesn't have any foe knowledge. Quest knowledge? Area knowledge? Oh, yeah. This is this rating right here is if you borrow a pawn from another player, they can actually rate them, including on their appearance. Before sending them back, and you get the review stats right there. Falling asleep? Alright, Radio, thanks for stopping by. You have a fantastic holiday tomorrow. Take care of yourself. I'm so glad you were able to stop by. I love seeing you. I'll talk to you later. Take care of yourself. Alright. How do I interact with Pawn?
Strongholds needn't be pretty.
No, it's not useful. Alright, let's see if... Do I need to talk to him to change their skills?
Have your pick. Any you like.
Let's see. Set skills for... Yeah, here we go. Let's see if I can learn her any new skills, too. Well, let's see what she's got first. Alright, so she doesn't have anything other than those three skills. So let's see if I can have her learn new skills. Ooh, I can. But it looks like it takes out of my pool of discipline, though. So I don't necessarily want to jump right into having her learn new skills. I'm probably going to want to teach myself some as well.
What will it be today? Have your pick.
But that's good to know. Alright. So that's cool. New skill get. I think that's the one we just talked to right there. So don't need to talk to her again. Base core. Alright, nothing around here we really need to do, so let's go ahead and move on. Let's see, who's, let's see, Rook?
If we're to journey...
How do I check his status? Right in here. Rook's level 6, so I can keep him around for a while. So no need to swap him out immediately. The thing, if I've understood this correctly, is your two temporary pawns don't actually gain XP or level up. So I can't just keep them around forever. I'm going to need to swap them out as need demands. But for right now, they're both powerful enough that it shouldn't be an issue. Alright, so... Do I actually have anything else I need to do in the camp? I don't think so. I'll look around a little bit more, but this seems like a pretty small area. And then after that, I guess I'll go to the inn and wait till morning. And then I'll go out and get the rest of the flowers I need, probably. And they're just breaking stuff behind me. Alright, cool. So I'll just head to the inn and wait out morning in that case. And I should be able to grab the rest of the flowers and finish this quest up.
We can safeguard. Have your pick. What will it be today?
Stay till morning. Alright, there we go. While you're connected online, your main pawn's attributes will be uploaded every time you rest at an inn. The main pawn you created can travel to other worlds online and assist other players in their travel. These adventures can result in new knowledge, items, and equipment they bring back when they return. Your main pawn will gain boons earned in other worlds at the inn as well. Visit often to keep current on any developments. Alright, so make sure we're stopping at the inn every once in a while to loan out my pawn and get cool stuff brought back from other worlds. Deal. Alright, flowers it is. I do like me some side quests.
Well sturdy, this place.
Plus I'll be able to try out my new spell. New area has been unlocked. Visit the Cassardi Pier at night if you would see it for yourself. Why at night? That's odd. Oh, it is? Yeah, this is the area.
I feel familiar with this area now.
So I think that quest marker might be pointing me towards the flowers I need, so let's head over in that direction. Let's see, I don't know if that's just leading me back to the starting town or if that's actually going to lead me towards some flowers. Wow, they are so chatty. I'm totally going to turn that off. Oh, here it is.
We have triumphed.
Oh, alright, so that's how I do it. So I haven't even tried out my primary magic. I've just been using my normal attack. Alright, cool. Let's try that out then. Where the heck is it? Behind me? Alright. Alright, good deal. I should be using that more.
Plants of all kind grow at the tree's feet, like so many verdant children.
Verdant children? Did he seriously just say that? My god. Alright, so yeah, the flowers haven't respawned around that one tree. That's unfortunate. So yeah, all it's doing is leading me back to town. So I'm going to need to do a little bit more exploring if I want to find more flowers, it looks like. Yeah, roots of large trees, I heard. But I only saw some by that one root there. See if there's any around this way. Oh, there's a plant. Nightcry. Yeah, let's not go back into that game, like, ever again. If you don't mind. Oh, hey! I think that might have been one of the ones we need. And here's a couple other plants as well. More Nightcry. So let's check the quests readout, see how we're doing on that one. Nope, still just the three.
The rocks here may hold ore.
Alright. So, yeah, that's the biggest tree around, and that's where I found the first of the flowers. I mean, you really can't sprint for very long in this game.
I'm here.
It debilitates the hell out of you when you use it up.
Plants of all kind grow at the tree's feet, like so many verdant children.
Oh my god, the pawn dialogue is just terrible. I'm trying to resist turning it off.
Who knows what lies in wait. Let's proceed with caution.
Because I really want to hear what they have to say, but it's just really bad. Alright, so that's what Fireball looks like.
Their kind hates ice and fire both.
Ooh, and that's my ice field. Good deal. I like it. Alright. Here's another big tree. Alright, cool. Quest complete. They're so bad. Alright, so it looks like a red quest marker on the map denotes a quest I can go ahead and turn in. So that's good to know. Oh. I could have sworn I opened that one already, but if there's more money in it, I'll take it. Alright, so as you saw, I want to try and not use all of my stamina, because that debilitates me for a second. Whereas otherwise, I can at least move at normal speed, as long as I don't use all of it. Kind of like the little dark Arisen thing in the corner, it's cute. Ooh, new cinema. Yeah, what's up?
Are you come to lead the pawns in a quest to slay the dragon?
Yeah, that's the idea. Equivocal husks.
Will or nil, the Arisen is always drawn to the dragon, as puppets strung in fate's own thread.
Alright, who are you?
Many have come before you, eager to stand tall atop the grand capstone of worldly truth that is the dragon.
Uh-huh.
Arrogance. The dragon is ever born anew into the world, and with it too, the Arisen. All Arisen seek out the dragon, but lucky are the few who attain an audience with the beast while yet they live.
Ah.
Ours is a weak, fragile world, and little within it is more frail than man.
You're super gross, dude.
In yon encampment, they gather up their knights and hired steel. They think to grow their numbers and hunt the dragon. But they shall soon learn their lot will e'er be as prey.
And thus did the Arisen meet the mystery douchebag of the forest. Who is he? What does he want? Why is he such a jerk about everything?
Seems we'll most like to find what we seek near trees.
A mysterious island known as Bitter Black Isle has appeared off the coast. I wonder if it's like a DLC thing or something. Hello, guy with a blinky thing above your head.
Chills just to think of it. I was. I didn't. I'll make no excuse, cousin. I hid in the well for fear of the dragon.
Oh, so that's why the well was sealed up. You moron.
Let me tell you this. You'd be wise to keep your distance from that pit. I was too craven to venture far. A lucky thing. A queer growl echoed back with the sound of water from further in.
Ooh.
There's aught down there. Mark my words. I could feel it, I could. You'll not see me going back down there to find out what. What? You mean to go down there? You're a right hero.
Hell yes.
If you're set on going, take this with you. It should have some use to it left. I'll not soon forget your bravery, cousin. Pray, just come back alive.
Alright. Investigate the well. Alright, let me make sure that lantern is set to my quick bar. In case I need to use it when it gets dark down there. Oh yeah, I keep forgetting they have inventories too. Not here. Let's go into Tools. Alright, yeah, it's set to 1. Alright, it has enough oil to burn for a while. Good deal. Into the well we go. As the game crashes. Beautiful. Alright, that was unexpected. So let's try reloading the game real quick and getting back in. First game crash of the night at, 2 hours in-ish? Not too bad. Hopefully, oh geez, hopefully it didn't, wasn't too long ago that it saved. I don't think it was, though. Hey, Durzok, got here just in time for the first game crash of the night. How are you doing this evening? Having a good holiday, I hope? Alright, let's jump back in there. Dragon's Dogma! Alright, time to find out where it saved last. Launching in offline mode? Why is it launching in offline mode? Doing good! I'm doing good as well. The options... How do I turn online mode back on? Connectivity? Online. Save changes. I decided I wanted to stream for a little longer than usual today, and wanted to stream something a little special today, so that's why we are playing Dragon's Dogma. We will be coming back to Mirror's Edge tomorrow to finish it off. Load game. Alright, time to see how far back it's saved before we crashed. Oh cool, right before the well, looks like. Excellent. Let's try going in the deadly well of crashing in again. Alright, made it this time. Let's see what's down here.
Which way should we go, Arisen?
Looks spooky. Alright, as they break all the stuff on my behalf. Said the leftward path bears the stink of death. Does that mean the rightward path is the good one?
This bridge is too far decayed to use.
Is there no way down?
It'll be easier going searching this area now. Oops, where are they going? Well, they seem to be all over the place. Should I just let them do their thing?
I'll heal your wounds.
Yeah, I guess I'll just let them do their thing for now. See, they said the bridge was too stagnant to use as I just walked over it. Alright, cool. She got her vocation ranked up. Good for her. Have you ever played this game before, Durzak? Any experience with it? Alright, looks like... I don't see anything else to see in this area unless we get on the river. But for now, I'd like to head over here and see what I can get out of that. Stink of death, I assume, means there's monsters. As I just knock bats down. Alright, cool. She's leveling up real fast. Nope, good deal.
An animal carcass. Was the victim of a monster mostly.
There we go. Ooh! Let's turn on my lamp so I can actually see where I'm going. Alright, so jumping is the only way to continue, they say, but apparently it's also pretty dangerous. So let's see what we can see down there. I think we can make that. Yep. Ooh. Hello, monsters. Tank them. Tank them. No, don't let them near. Alright, that's getting them. One of them picking up items as we're fighting? Don't do that! Oops! Oh, wow! Oh my god! Wow! He took me out so fast! The only thing I know is that wolves hunt in packs. Wow! They killed me so fast there! Alright, so I'm going to have to be super careful fighting these guys now. It's possible I'm not supposed to do this quest yet. That's also a possibility, but we're gonna work our way through here for right now. Let's see what we can find. Yeah, the pawns are so chatty in this game. It's a little maddening. I can't even bash these rats down properly. Alright, so let's use the light to explore down here a little bit. Get some stagnant shrooms, I guess. Luckily, it looks like I'm getting experience from when the pawns get some kills as well, so that's nice. Alright, so if I can walk down here, I'll go ahead and explore down in the river a little bit, see if there's anything down here. Oh, empty chest. I wonder if one of them already grabbed it. Ooh, there's another chest up here. Get that one off. Didn't notice that last time when I was in the dark. That's a lesson for me, then. Pickled mushrooms. I have no idea what that is, but we'll check it out later. Oh, alright, so this does lead somewhere. My condolences. There we go. Knock that down, get the goodies. Oops. Alright, so these monsters seem to be given a decent amount of XP, so it's possible this is an area I'm not necessarily supposed to be in yet. But if I'm getting this much XP, it might be worth checking out still. I'm going to stick down here for a little bit. See what I can find. Oh, let's see. Some more boxes to break.
Nowhere to go but up.
Alright. Good deal. Check the chest first. Wow, 1,000 gold. Alright, that's very nice. That'll get me some new items once I get back to town after this. Really? Jump across where? Somewhere to jump to? Oh, I might be able to go up. That's interesting. Ooh. Oh, wow, those bats do so much damage. Holy crap. Yeah, heal me up, dude.
I shall restore your health. Hold on.
Wow, alright, I'm gonna have to get some more armor once we get back to town. I don't know if those bats are mind-blowingly difficult, or if, I'm just, have really weak armor. Or, actually, there's a good chance it's both. Luckily, Rook here is healing me up whenever I'm taking too much damage, so hopefully he keeps up on that. That is a really good thing to have, because I can heal, but I'm not actually sure, 100% certain how to heal myself yet. Bash these giant-ass rats down. Because they're gross. Now, is that it? Oh, I'm back at the entrance. Oh, sorry, I must have just made a big loop there. Alright, let me save real quick. Save and continue. And then I'm going to go down that other path that had the big lizard creatures that killed the crap out of me. So I want to try taking another crack at them before we get too far. Oh wow, those rats give 25 XP apiece. That's even more than the bats. So if nothing else, I am farming here a little bit. Alright, I'll check around here. And that's not where I jumped down. We followed the path a little bit farther. Through all these... Oh, jeez. Oh, yeah, see, I leveled up just bashing these rats. That's amazing. So this seems like a good grindy quest to start the game out. You know, they always joke about kill 10 rats quests at the start of a game, but this is working really well for me. Alright. Now... I wonder if I could shoot him from up here. That'd be pretty hilarious. That was weird. Oh man, I can't hit him from up here. Sweet. Let's cheese him. Oh my god, he can almost jump up here. Holy crap, they can jump. So these monsters are really strong. Luckily, if I'm cheesing... Oh, not the rat! Them! Hit him with some fireballs, let him know who's boss. Oh shoot, how do I... hang on a sec. There we go. What is going on there? Oh, I keep hitting the wrong key. I keep trying to hit the left control to trigger my skills, and instead I'm hitting the Windows key. That's no good. Alright, we're running him down, but that one guy just like one-shotted me, so I want to be real careful and don't want to assume anything. Alright, so they're getting knowledge of these creatures too, so that's good. Let's keep wearing them down here. Oh, we've almost got him. We've almost got him. Oh, that one's almost dead. Cool, got that one. So now how about the other one? There. Doesn't look like he's actually weak against fire, but I'll keep wailing on him. Oh, cool, so you hit him in the tail to make him weaker. Cool, I like that. I only see two of my pawns down there. Where's the other guy? Hello, other guy. Is he dead? No, there he is. Wonder where he was during all that. Alright, well, there's plenty of stuff to pick up down here, so good on that. But they're still acting like there's somebody else down here. I don't see any more enemies, though, as my lantern goes out. Oh, there he is! Holy crap, he's right in front of me. Oh man, there's a whole bunch of them over here. Alright, let's start wailing on him. Get him from behind where we can. I don't want to just wade in there since they can kill me so quick, so... Alright, cool, so I can hit multiple with that, so that's good. Let's keep wailing on him with that explodey fireball. Doesn't do a ton of damage though, but they seem to know that they can hit the tail now. So I'll let them handle that. So like I said, these guys are really powerful, but I think that means that I'm going to be able to... I'm going to be able to get some good XP from this and maybe get a really nice start to the game. Because this really is my first legit quest that I've been doing. Not really going to count the Gathering Flowers quest. Alright, good. Rook is doing a pretty good job of healing everybody. Are we even hurting it? Yeah, you're hurting it. Draw near fallen allies and press E to revive them. If pawn remains unconscious too long, they will be forfeit. Oops. Alright, let's go get her back up. I don't know how she got so separated, but whatever. Get back with the main group. Alright, he's taking the most damage, so let's see if we can finish this one that's rolling around on the ground off. Oops, hey! I'm gonna stay back. Ooh! Oh, Nyla's down again. Ooh, two of them are down. Alright, you get up. You get up. Alright. So their max health are knocked down, so I'm gonna have to be careful. We really need to get one of these down at least to decrease their numbers. It's a little tough to target in here, because there isn't any sort of auto-target in this game. So I've just kind of got to point at the guy I want to hit and then mash the button. Tuna's down again. Alright, that's a level up for me. Her up, get her back up. I think we've just got the one now. Let's just take him out. We should be good. Oh, she's in bad shape. Alright. Once this guy moves, I'll be able to get in there and... Oops. Reviver. Alright, cool. It's a hell of a fight right here, especially for the start of the game. There! Alright. Whew! Good deal. That was a hell of a quest. right at the start of the game, too. I shall restore your health. Hold on. I have no idea what max level in this game is, though. But either way, we took one heck of a beating down there. So we'll have to see if, I have to see if all those levels we just picked up add to me getting really strong right at the start of the game. That'd be really cool. Alright, so let's see what else there is down here. See, the cave branches off into here. Ooh, alright. This looks promising. Turn my lantern back on. Oops. Alright.
I shall restore your health. Hold on.
Ooh. Ooh, traps? I think there was traps on the floor. Oh, cripes, now I'm poisoned. I have no idea how to deal with poison. I think I've got some restoratives, actually. We'll see. Tis barred shut, might be able to break the bolt. Alright. Brute force, I'll take it. So where does this lead now? Uh-oh, I hear things... Oh, geez, spiders! Well, at least they don't seem to be too tough of opponents. But they give okay experience, at least. Hit him, hit him! Oh, geez, camera, help me out here. Is that all of them? I think that's all of them. Sweet. Ow, nope. Missed one. Gross. Always spiders. Without fail. Alright. Cool, let's get the rest of the stuff in here. This is a really big cave for just being underneath the well. I wonder what this was supposed to be in canon. Flask of water. Yeah. Yeah, I hear you there. Let's see, lantern? Lantern went out a while ago. There we go. We got the lantern back on. So let's continue exploring down this cavern. See what we can find. Freaking spiders. Already! Already. Only a few hours into the game and we already ran into our first spiders. Alright. This looks like it leads out, so I wonder where it leads to. Since we came in through the actual... entrance to the well. Huh. Just a big old cave entrance somewhere. Let's check the map, see where we need to get back to. Wow, alright, so we are a ways away. Alright, cool. Let's start heading back in that direction, though, so we can start turning in these quests.
Care to find out where this path leads? We are like to find a flower by the grand tree ahead.
Alright, so yeah, what we'll do is we'll head back to the encampment. We'll use the inn there real quick to heal everybody's damage back up. Since, if you didn't see it earlier, if you haven't played the game before, one thing they mentioned is that when you take damage, it affects your max damage, or your max health, in addition to actually doing your damage. You can see on my health bar there's green, which is my current health. There's gray, which is my current max health. And then that little bit past the gray is my max health. Oh god, you started with Dragon's Dogma already. You should have told me, because the class system is rather complicated. Hey, Drav. Happy holidays and welcome to the stream. How are you doing tonight? Yeah, Dragon's Dogma was actually a super, super, super last minute thing. I only decided I was going to be playing it about 45 minutes before the stream started. And I started the stream early tonight. I started it at, an hour early by my time. So it wasn't very heavily planned. I was actually, to tell you the truth, originally I was gonna play, I was actually gearing up to play Jade Empire tonight, but I was having some trouble capturing it with my capture software. So at very last second I switched over to this. I did do a little research before I started playing though, Drav. And got some of the basics of the class system down, I think.
Have your pick, any you like.
Alright, so let's rest at the inn first. See you till morning. But if you've got anything to offer, I am all ears. Right now, I'm playing a mage, and my primary pawn is a warrior. And my two temporary pawns are another mage and a ranger, whatever they're called in this game, which I don't recall. Alright, let that access the server. And save real quick. Alright, I'm back at the Riftstone. Let's go ahead and see if we want to buy some more skills. Alright, so you already know that stat growth is decided by the class that you are when you level up. Yes, that I heard. And so, what I heard is that this isn't one of those games where you want to stick with a whole class for very long. I don't know. I only thought I only got the choice between the three core classes. So she's whichever one is the core that I got the choice from. I'll check in a second.
Have your pick. Any you like.
Learn or set skills. Learn skills. Alright, so I actually have a decent amount of discipline now. So let's see. Levitate would be nice. But what can I teach my, She's a fighter is what she is, yeah. Yeah, so we're good. And she's already level 6 as well, so that's pretty cool. Let's see, broad cut. While falling back, that sounds nice. Sending lightweight foes into the air, that sounds nice as well. Well suited to bringing down flying foes. I think I'm pretty good with that, so I'm not too worried about that. Wow, she can learn a lot of stuff too. Advanced form of base skill, adding a new pattern to chains of sword slashes. That sounds kind of nice. Appends a tackle to a forceful jab. That sounds cool too. And augments. Extend the limit of your health. That sounds nice. I do want to learn my stuff first, though. So let's see, I think I'm probably going to want to take Levitate and slap that. I don't know. Smites an enemy from above with tongues of lightning. If you had told me you wanted to play Dragon's Dogma, I could have told you there are three classes where you really don't want to bother with stat min-maxing, while the rest of the classes require some planning to be effective. Well, like I said, it was a real last-second decision, but I've been having fun with it so far. So that's the important thing, I think. Alright, so the boons look like they're going to be nice too, but I don't want to slap those on yet. Let me go ahead and get the lightning skill, since that seems like a pretty basic thing. And I'll stick with that for right now. Or do I want to learn to levitate? I think I do. The classes that have a stat growth that pretty much allow you not to switch class are a lot of assassin, ranger, and sorcerer. I don't think I can switch to any of those yet, because those are the combo classes, I believe, right? Alright, so I'll take that too. Now let's start equipping things. Yes. Alright, let's see. Alright, so yeah, we'll equip that to my E. And there we go. There's two E's to switch, either with level 10 in the main city. Yeah, so I haven't gotten quite there yet. But for right now, I am enjoying Sorcerer. So I'm not in any huge hurry to switch just yet.
Have your pick, any you like. Come again soon.
Alright. I do think I'm going to have to switch. I'm going to switch Nayla, though. Because she's level 4 and I'm level 7, so I might want to see if I can up her a little bit. Get a slightly better pawn instead of her. Let's see, who are we going to get? I'd like to get another ranger if possible. To replace her, just to keep a nice little balance there. Ooh, she'd be expensive, though. She's really high level. Let's see how expensive, actually. Let's take a look.
Yes, Arisen.
0 rift stones. I thought that would be pricier than it is. View details. Wow. Actually, pretty high invocation rank and level, so holy shit. Yeah, let's go grab her. Or if you go to the starting town at night and go to the docks, there's a woman there you can... Yeah, I saw them talk about Bitter Black. There you can switch to any level in return. And you're a mage who has an awful stat growth and pretty much only has it used as a healer support. So it's in your entrances change that. Alright. Possibly. Like I said, I'm enjoying shooting fireballs at dudes. That is pretty fun. So I'm not sure how quick I'm going to want to change out of that. But we'll see. We'll see. Switch in that pawn. Who will you release from the party? We'll release Nyla, since she's the lowest level in the party.
I am honored to travel with you.
Alright, good deal.
May our paths cross again.
Sure. Alright, do I want to grab a new mage is the question. Nah, Rook's doing pretty good for right now. I don't see anybody tremendously high level past that. So let's go ahead and head out for right now. Exit the rift. Pawns on your level are always for free, or if they are pawns of one of your friends or your friend's list, pawns with a higher level than that cost a good amount of rift stones. Yeah, I'm not sure why that level 19 was free then, but I'll take it. Alright, so... having done that, let's go ahead and back to the starting town so we can turn in a couple of those quests then.
We are a vagabond people, born in a drift.
So what's your history with Dragon's Dogma then? Hey, Brad, thank you. That's actually better than the last compliment I got, which the last compliment was someone said, it looks like someone shaved my head and then exposed my skull to the bare air. So yeah, I think I'll take the shalom any day over that. Thank you. How are you doing today, hey Brad? You having a good holiday so far? Level 19 is free because it was a pawn of someone on my friend's list. Huh. I didn't know anybody on my friend's list had played this before. I'm going to have to investigate that later. But that is cool. Alright. Go ahead and gather some stuff. So, have you beaten this game before, Drev? And if so, have you beaten it more than once? What kind of character did you play when you beat it originally? Oh my god, she's got a little chipmunk voice too. That's gonna get irritating. Cold but content with a full belly. That sounds like a good way to spend the holidays, hey Brad. I am doing all right. I decided I wanted to give all of my viewers a nice little Christmas present by doing an extra long stream, so that is exactly what we're doing right now. Oops, goblins. Go kick their asses. Boom. See how they like that. Oh my god, that chipmunk voice. It's amazing. Let's just finish him off. There we go, they were no problem. That chipmunk voice is gonna get to me. Pawns that spawn by default in the pawn dimension are usually pretty weak, so what you should do when you want a new pawn is to click on the stone, click search, then you can decide which pawn you want. Alright. That's good to know.
What of the flower hunt monster? We mustn't keep her waiting.
Beat it twice, once on normal and once on New Game Plus. Sounds fun. So what kind of builds did you play on those playthroughs? Oh, dang it. I was trying to stop right before I ran out of stamina, but no dice. Yeah, we'll stop right there. Yeah, I getcha. I think eventually I'm going to have to turn off pawn chatter. I'll turn off pawn... My staff is glowing, gotta get that checked out ASAP. Only if the glow lasts for more than 4 days. I think.
You've slain the monsters of the well, have you?
I really am. Thank you for noticing.
I think upon it, 'twas my hiding in the well what brought the danger to light. I take no credit, mind.
Good, because they're not giving you any.
I simply feared I'd be blamed for releasing monsters upon the village for having opened up the well.
I'm going to blame you regardless, so.
It is a relief in all you're doing, cuz. Here, I owe you at least this much for all you've done.
At least.
I shall strive to learn from your example. Commit myself to becoming a soldier fit to defend the land and its people. Honest.
You're not going to do well at that because you suck, but good on you for having the initiative.
I've gained quest knowledge.
Sweet. Alright. Now we got to turn in the flower quest while we're in the area.
I feel familiar with this area now.
The talk cycle? You mean on the guys following me around? I think I'm going to turn off their subtitles, if nothing else, so they're not flooding the screen constantly. Pawn subtitles off, yes. Let's do that. It's so weird that backspace is the save changes button in the menus. That takes some getting used to. You played a magic archer. Stay a sorcerer for the majority of the time. Kind of killed the fun of the game because I couldn't play what I wanted. See, that's not what I want to do. I want to play whatever the hell I want.
Bring the mixture calls for two types of... I ask you this favor.
Yes. Sunbright.
Oh, brought the rest of them, have you? My thanks, cousin. All that remains is to find some moon glow. A pinch mixed with these will make a fine medicine.
Oh, the guy I was just talking to? Yeah, I was complaining earlier in the game that the direction of the vocals sounds really terrible. Everyone sounds... Their pitch is off, everyone's a little too enthusiastic. Nobody sounds like a natural person you'd be talking to at any time. Should have played Ranger or Assassin, they have badass stat growth for physical, and the only times you change class if you want to add some magic attack. Alright, do I have any Moonglow right now? Let's check now my status. Quest, let's check my quests. Now collect necessary moon glow. Now if I do have any moon glow, it doesn't say that I have it. Let's try talking to her and see if I have any.
The wounded need medicine.
Yeah, I got it. Wait, what did she say there?
The mixture. I ask you this favor because...
Alright, so no, I don't have the right flower, so I need to get some moon glow, whatever that is. Looks like I've got another mark on my map over... Where is that? Down by the beach, maybe? Let's check that. Oh, that's probably to the that island they were talking about earlier. I have no idea what's going on there.
Where do the curing flowers grow? Have you had a look by the shore? If not now, I recall seeing some.
Alright, so we gotta find a place to rest and then we'll come back at night for the moon glow. I wonder how your pawn can be three levels lower than you. Usually the game sends you to get the main pawn at only one level lower than you. Alright, careful there, Drav. I appreciate the advice, but as far as the moon glow thing, I don't want you to give away the solutions to the quest right away. Like that one, I figured it out right as you were saying it, but I don't actually know if there's anywhere I can rest in this village. I have to figure that out. Just rest at any one of the beds. Just take this bed. Take it, rest. I think there was an inn. Oh, yeah. Oh, I was right at the inn. That's handy. Alright, so I'll rest here till tonight.
You picking flowers for? Pray, just be cautious, cousin.
No, I have no idea how the main pawn didn't get to... Or I think my main pawn is the same level as me, isn't she? I'll double check in a second.
Monsters grow bolder by night. I do not fancy that. If you come by me, what can I do you?
Rest for 50G. That's a little more manageable. Stay till nightfall. There we go. Who do you think you are? This is an RPG. Pay for sleeping. But this is my hometown. Gotta be some sort of, discount for that. So let me ask you one thing, Drav. They were talking about that mysterious island, and it sounded like DLC or something. Is that something I want to be doing soon, or is that something added on to the game? So visited this special chair to mentor your main pawn. What? You can give direction on how you'd like them to act in battle and while out in the field. Similarly, you can also advise your main pawn how you'd like to have them speak to you. The knowledge? What? Okay.
I work to keep my fellow pawns safe in battle. Does this please you, Arisen?
Yeah.
Understood. Aiding my fellow pawns will be my first priority. If they fall in battle, I shall bring them to you, Master.
Okay.
I try to speak or remain silent as the situation demands. Would you have me continue in this way, Master?
Yes?
As you wish. I will attempt to be more talkative from now on.
Oops. How do I get out of this? Do I have to do all these questions first? Yes.
My all is yours to shape, Master. Should I suffer a deadly blow, how shall I voice my anguish?
As you are.
It shall be done. Should fate see you fall and come to rise again, how shall I offer my support?
As you are.
It shall be done.
Alright, I'll look into that more when I need to, I suppose.
A fine bit of fortune you've come into.
Fie, what to do, what to do. If only there was some hero to aid a poor unfortunate lass such as I.
Oh, this seems like a trap. Oh yes, the content there is DLC content, but it's a bit difficult to explain. Oh, so it's like a super hard, like, post-game thing?
Steel and drove the dragon from Cassidus, yes? I heard about that. And of course you know me. I come here now and again to restock my wares. You do recall me, yes? Madeline? Finest peddler in all Grancis?
Sure, why not?
Ravishing beauty of legend and song? Madeline.
Oh yeah, of course.
Well, no matter. I've bigger problems. These are dark days, so terrible as to drive even I to the brink of tears.
Poor thing.
And yet, just when I need the aid of one both clever and strong, you arrive.
Yeah, go ahead and spring the trap. Let's get straight to it.
Fortune means us to partner together. Don't you agree?
Indeed.
Only a fool could mistake the thread of destiny what links us. You will be my savior true, and after me, the world entire.
Yeah.
And with that, we must be off. I trust you know of the encampment outside the village.
Yes, I do.
I must travel there with all speed, but the wilds are perilous of late.
True facts.
Would you see me there safely?
Yeah, that's a nice short walk. I can do that. You do it anytime you want. People have been starting it with level 1 already. I doubt I'm good enough for that. I did it after the final boss because you find the best weapon on the island. To make it rather easy. Alright, I'm going to go to the shore before I escort her and see if I can find some of those moon glue. Hello? Oh, you only wanted the weapon for New Game Plus. Alright, that's fair. I just wanted to pick some flowers. Alright, I thought they said to look by the flowers by the shore, but whatever's going on out there, I'm not going to look into it yet. Empty flask. Grab that. Picking up garbage off the shore now. What a dignified hero I am. Oh, yeah, escort quest fails. I should probably just go ahead and do the escort quest then. Get it out of the way. May as well. Oh, that's the bitter black woman. Yeah, I'm going to avoid her till late game then. That sounds horrifying. Yeah, as somebody that hasn't really gotten very far in Dark Souls, I think it'd be best if I put that off as long as possible. Maybe late game I'll come back there just for shits and giggles and give it a try. But for right now, I am in no hurry, that's for sure. Alright. But now I've already got turned around again, so... Which way am I going? That's a good question. The main aim is not getting lost, but I don't think that's going to happen. Oh, hey, I found a graveyard. That's spooky. Well, this escort quest is not going well so far, considering I'm lost. I'll see if there's anything interesting up here, I guess.
This looks interesting.
Church? Village Chapel? I'll have to come back later. You can activate quests as the main quest and get quest markers on the map then. Yeah. Probably should do that. Let's see. Quests. Guard duty. Despite her safety concerns, Madeline has a knack for watering off. Heed her closely as you travel the encampment. Set as priority. There you go. RPGs have maps. What? Blowing my mind here, Drav. Dropping knowledge, and I don't even know if I can handle all of it. Don't know. Alright. So, let's keep heading around. See if we can figure out how to get to that exit. Yeah, it doesn't seem like there's a shortcut key to get straight to the map. I have to go from the escape menu, which is a little odd. It seems a little unusual for me.
Searching in this area now. My kind knows neither death nor age. Tis likely one reason humans shun us. This way leads out a field.
Just going around smashing stuff. And yeah, I want to check something real quick. Status. Yeah, I'm level 7 and my main pawn is level 7 too, so that's good. Alright, they said the monsters are tougher at night though, and bring them on. I want to see what we want to do. Who do you want to play it? Ranged? Probably ranged. Ranged is sort of my default whenever I'm playing any sort of video game. With any sort of RPG game anyway. Alright, let's get Madeline to the encampment. I think she's the gray dot on my map. What? Is she getting distracted over there? Come on, Madeline. I see enemies up ahead. Get their attention. Oops, that didn't work. There we go. That got their attention. Oh, I should test out my lightning. Aw, dang. No need for it. Oh, that was the healing, not the lightning. Forgot which button I put it on. Why did you start as a mage then? Because the mage had the healing ability, and I wanted to at least snag the healing ability before I got too far. The hell? Something attacking us?
What's this?
Thought I heard somebody fighting us. Didn't see anything, though. Alright, let's continue on.
Aha, gold.
Yeah, my idea was I'd start as a mage, I'd get the healing abilities, and then later on I would switch over to the ranger. Having the healing ability to use, perhaps?
Hold a moment. There's art here.
Man, she's easily distracted. Come on! What I did was always grab a mage pawn as a heal slave. Yeah, my mage pawn has been doing pretty much all of the healing, so. As with Kingdoms of Amalur, my initial plan has already failed disastrously. But hey, it's good to have traditions, I think. It's good to have traditions. No, you can't use abilities from other classes when you switch. Alright, so what is it that you unlock? You just unlock, cross-class skills by leveling up one class? So, like, I can get the mage slash ranger by leveling up mage and then leveling up ranger? Is that it? Am I understanding that correctly?
Success. And all thanks goes to your fine work.
Yep.
Best be inside, don't you think?
Sure. It's a strange zoom in there. You can only keep the passive effects from other classes. Well, I got the thing, the passive that, stops me from taking a bunch of fall damage, so that's a good thing right there, because oh my god, I'm going to be falling off cliffs, let me tell you, Drav.
This may sound
Excuse me?
Please, I must make for the capital, but times are dark and my purse light.
Damn it.
It's a terrible curse being poor. Times are, it takes all I have just to keep the tears back.
Oh my god.
Will you spare some gold? I would repay you, of course. At some point. Most likely.
Sure, what the hell?
I am so very much in love with you at this moment.
Shut up, Madeline.
A woman's heart is a dangerous creature, but you know well how to take it.
Just get to the capital, Madeline.
Oft has it been said, a poor life is a happy one. I have never found this to be true. If ever fortune sees you to Grand Sorin and me to setting up my shop, you must come visit. I shall even give you a discount. A small one.
Well, thanks for that, Madeline. So high maintenance. What kind of a merchant doesn't have any money? So, for example, when you're a ranger, you want to have good physical attack power. The warrior class, for example, has a passive that gives you a nice 20% physical attack power. So most people... Alright, play warrior a bit to unlock that. Alright, that makes sense. That makes a lot of sense, actually. Alright, let's see what her wares are. Huh. The heck are these? Oh, it's like amplifiers. That's interesting. I haven't seen any of those before. Materials. Other weapons. Some nice ranger weapons. Nothing I can use right now. Tunic. They're better than what I've got, but what I've got is crap, so I don't think I want to use those quite yet. Leather banding. I've got a lot of money, so I think I'd actually like to get some decent... Holy crap! What is this now? Plus 10 strength, plus 10 magic? Well, this seems nice. Madeline has the best boobs in the game. Of course, Trav! A stat you'd know off the top of your head. Those devs love to push them out. You're not wrong. All right, well, this sounds nice. Plus 10 strength, plus 10 magic. Sure. Let's pick it up. Why not? Got a decent amount of cash right now, so I may as well spend a little of it. Upgrade my little hat there. All right, so I equipped that. Good deal. Alright, never mind. If you want to be a ranger, I recommend you talk to the nice woman at the shore and switch class. Already? I suppose may as well already. I can already see mage isn't working out for me, so might as well. Wait, why does she have something to say to me?
Sturdy as she is, have my doubt she needs an escort at all.
What a jerk! Pawn's all sassy and stuff. Actually, you're super poor considering what the prices for weapons for advanced classes are. Well, I don't need to get into advanced classes just yet. Alright. Back to finding Moonglow. And it looks like I can't set it as a priority since it's my only quest. But whatever. So we'll just head out and start on that again. Alright, so let's head back to the starting town again. See if we can... See if we can find some of those flowers along the way, maybe.
You could stand to commission some new roads.
Oh my gosh, that chipmunk voice.
Perhaps we'll find more among the crags that litter this place.
Alright. Well, in the early game, you level up so fast that you want to waste quite some stat gains by activate the quest as main quest. I don't think I can, because it's the only quest I have. Yes, he said his priority is marked out there. I ran past the Moonglow 3 times now? What? Yeah, it's not letting me set it as the main quest. Well, where the heck is the Moonglow then? Is it out here on the road somewhere? Is that where I'm walking past it?
Perhaps we'll find more among the crags that litter this place.
Is it down by the shore? I thought somebody said it was down by the shore. I don't see anything down by the shore, though. The shore outside the starting town. Alright, so I'll head there then. Yeah, before when I was picking up the other flowers, it didn't put a marker on my map either. All I had to do is listen to my companion say, it's by the big tree, go to the big tree! Over and over and over again. Didn't even go to that shore. Did I have to go farther out than I was going? They're a monster? Oh, wolves. Ow. Ooh, he's on me. That was dangerous. Never had that happen before.
Strength in numbers, Arisen.
What's this?
Alright then. Some new enemies to fight. Good deal. Oh, I needed to go farther. Alright, well, let's hit it up then. I thought it would be, like, right by the shore or something. My excuse will be that I'm just trying to drive you insane, Drav. That's all I'm doing here. Alright, let's run down here. See what we got. Oh, yeah, Jesus. I thought that was the start of the water there. Looked a little weird in the light I was standing in. Alright, moon glow. Already succeeded. What better can I do for the holidays, I figured, Drav. Oh, here's moon glow. Oh, is that it? I just needed the one? That was easy then. Yeah, what else could I do for the holidays, Drav, than giving you the gift of insanity? That's what I'm figuring. Alright, let's take out some goblins here. Oops. Oh, they're all jumping around. Think they're all special. It is rather satisfying to be setting enemies on fire there, I'll say that much. Level 8! And increased my vocation, that's nice. Head over here. What are they doing? Setting a bonfire or something? Allow me to help then. Here, have some more fire. Look at how helpful I am. I'm so generous. So generous. I don't know how much more helpful I can be than how helpful I am right now. Lucky you have tons of food, so you're happy. What kind of stuff are you having? Do you actually have a holiday meal today, or just sort of chowing down so far? You know I love me some food, chat. Alright, let's see if we can find a way back up. Yeah, if anybody's having some sweet holiday dinners today, feel free to tell me about it. So that is the kind of thing I like talking about. I don't think I'm going to be having I think I might be having something later. We'll see how things work out. But so far yesterday, I had the traditional bachelor food of Christmas in America, which is Chinese takeout. Which, to be fair, is delicious. In its own right, nothing spectacular, but delicious. Alright, so... And it crashed again! Oh my god! Thank you, game, for crashing. That's the second time it's crashed today. Well, it's actually been 3 hours since I started playing, so I'm actually going to take a quick break to refresh my drink and stretch my legs. So give me about